Today let us see about zinc phosphate cement, which is one of the oldest looting cements available in literature, which is in use since the 19th century. To start with, let us see about the composition of the components of zinc phosphate, which consists of a powder component and a liquid component. The powder consists of mainly 75% of zinc oxide and 13% of magnesium oxide, along with some radio opaque powders. The zinc oxide and the magnesium oxide are sintered above 1000 degrees Celsius and then ground into a very fine powder. The liquid consists of phosphoric acid, which is the main component, up to 40 to 60%. Then water is the second main component, along with aluminium phosphate, which is about 2 to 3%. In some cases, zinc phosphate is also added to the liquid. The liquid mainly controls the pH and it is usually acidic pH. Now let us see the setting reaction of the zinc phosphate cement. When the phosphoric acid, that is the liquid, is mixed with the powder, the phosphoric acid dissolves the zinc oxide in the powder component and then reacts with the aluminium phosphate, which is in the liquid component, and forms a zinc aluminophosphate gel. This gel forms a case or a covering over the unreacted zinc oxide particles. Therefore, the set cement contains unreacted zinc oxide particles, which is covered or enveloped in the amorphous matrix of this zinc aluminophosphate gel. Now let us see how to manipulate zinc phosphate cement. We need a glass slab and a long spatula, metallic spatula, for the manipulation. The reaction is basically exothermic. Therefore, it is better to use a cool slab to dissipate the heat and use a wider area of the slab while mixing to dissipate the heat. Now the powder is divided into 6 increments at least for the purpose of reducing the heat generated. The powder liquid ratio depends on the manufacturer's recommendation, and after incrementally adding the segments to the powder liquid and mixing for about 15 to 20 seconds before adding the next increment, a total time of 1.5 to 2 minutes occurs during this mixing process. The prolongation of the mixing time increases the setting time also. Now, how to find out whether the mixed cement is ready for looting? The string test helps here. If a string of cement can be lifted up to 12 mm to 19 mm from the glass slab using a spatula, then the cement is ready for looting. If a string extends greater than 19 mm, then the cement is too viscous and is not ideal for looting. Now, let us see certain factors which affects the working time and the setting time. The powder particle size. If it is finer, it accelerates the cement setting. The loss of water actually lengthens the setting time. Therefore, adding water during mixing time can accelerate the reaction. Now, to prolong the working time, we need to use a cool glass slab. The slab temperature should be above the dew point so that water will not interfere with the setting time. Now, when the slab is cool, the exothermic reaction heat is dissipated and it prolongs the working time. Now let us see the properties of zinc phosphate cement. The mechanism by which retention of cement to the tooth occurs is by mechanical retention. It is not chemical retention like in GIC cement, it is purely mechanical retention. Therefore, the use of liner could affect this retention property. The mechanical properties include a compressive strength of 104 MPa, a tensile strength of 5.5 MPa, and a model elastic modulus of 13 GPa, which makes the cement a strong and stiff cement compared with the other counterparts. And the biological consideration include the acidic nature of the cement being cytotoxic to humans. Especially when the remaining dendrite thickness is less and zinc phosphate cement is used as a looting cement, then we have to be careful regarding the acidic nature, which could affect the viable pulp. Therefore, a calcium hydroxide liner can be used in younger patients for whom the dentinal tubules are wider and the acids are conducted to the pulp faster, but the use of a liner can affect the retention, which is also need to be considered. Now finally, what are the uses of zinc phosphate cement? It was commonly used as a looting cement and it can be also used as a base and also sometimes as a restorative material. But in recent days, there are many other better alternatives for zinc phosphate cement, which has reduced its use. Thus, we saw about zinc phosphate cement as soon as possible. Let us see you soon in the next video.